दिस इज द नेक्स्ट पार्ट ऑफ सॉलिड वेस्ट मैनेजमेंट मॉड्यूल. सो दैट इज स्टोरेज, हैंडलिंग एंड ट्रांसपोर्टेशन ऑफ सॉलिड वेस्ट. इन प्रीवियस टू पार्ट्स वी हैव सीन सोर्स एंड टाइप्स ऑफ सॉलिड वेस्ट एंड स्टोरेज, जनरेशन, कलेक्शन एंड हैंडलिंग ऑफ सॉलिड वेस्ट. सो इन दिस पर्टिकुलर मॉड्यूल और पार्ट वी आर गोइंग टू सी द हैंडलिंग एंड ट्रांसपोर्टेशन ऑफ सॉलिड. So, after collection of solid waste, the next part or next step is storage. So, what is storage? So, storage we can done in galvanized steel dustbin or paper sack or public bins. So, these are some kind of bins or containers in which we are collected and store the solid waste. The handling, storage and processing of solid waste at the source before they are collected is the second of the six functional elements in the solid waste management system. Waste handling and sorting involves the activities associated with management of waste until they are placed in store container for the collection. The handling also encompasses the movement of loaded container to the point of collection. Sorting of waste component is an important step in the handling and storage of solid waste at the source. For example, the best place to separate waste material for reuse and recycling is at the source of generation. Households are becoming more aware of the importance of separating newspaper and cardboards, bottled glass, kitchen waste and ferrous and non-ferrous material. So, sorting is done at the household level. So, this is the typical flow diagram which shows the segregation at the source, minimization at the source. For example, segregation is done at household. Then this waste is going for the waste collection from source to segregation center. Then is come to the waste segregation into degradable to non-degradable. Then again non-degradable waste, we are separate out the recycling plant composting or from organic waste size reduction by aerobic decomposition. The waste product is converted into the stable form, that is agricultural land, manure or garden use. So these are some steps. So passing through collection from source of waste to segregation center, and at segregation center we are segregated the different type of waste. For example, non-degradable and degradable waste we are separated out at the segregation source. And organic and inorganic material we are separated out. So some part of some type of waste are reusable and recyclable. So that waste also we are separated out and reuse and recycle it frequently. So again there are two types. First is on-site storage of solid waste. The first phase to manage solid waste is at home level. It requires facilities for temporarily storing of refuse on the premises. Individual householder or business owner has responsibility for on-site storage of solid waste. For individual home, industries and other commercial centers, proper on-site storage of solid waste is the beginning of disposal. Because of upkept on simple dump are sources of nuisance, flies, smells and other hazards. So the factors that should be considered in on-site storage of solid waste are the type of container to be used, the location where container to be kept, the public health and the collection method and time. So, all the storage facilities depending on these factors. So first is storage container. The garbage and refuse generated in kitchen and other work should be collected and stored in properly designed and constructed waterproof garbage container or garbage cans, or we can call it as waste bins. So the can or receptacles can be constructed from galvanized iron sheet or plastic material. They should have tightly fitting covers. They must be of such a size that when full, they can be lifted easily by one man. They should be located in a cool place on platform at least 30 cm above ground level. Then after putting in garbage, they should be kept covered. Because of the decomposable or degradable material present in this garbage, so the organic matter present in that solid waste, they are getting decomposed and the foul gases are released. So that for this purpose, we are putting cover on the garbage bins. The bins must be emptied at least daily and maintained in clean condition. An adequate number of suitable containers should be provided with proper platform with receptacle stand. The number may depend on amount, type and establishment where they need. Then second one is container size. First is type of container. Second one is size of container or capacity of container. Consideration should be given for the size of the loaded container that must be hauled the collection vehicle or to the disposal site. Therefore, container size for ash up to 80 to 128 liter, mixed refuse should not exceed 120 to 128 liter, rubbish up to 200 liter, office waste is 10 to 20 liter, kitchen waste is up to 40 liter, and garbage is 48 to 80 liter. So this is approximate capacity of each type of collection system. Plastic liner for can and wrapping for garbage reduce the need for cleaning of can and bulk containers, keep down odor, rat and fly breeding. So these are some types of waste container. That is, yellow color is for garbage collection, red is for hazardous waste collection and blue is for commercial waste collection. So sometimes we are applying color coding for dustbins. So for on-site storage of solid waste, the galvanized metal is preferable for garbage storage because it is resistant to corrosion. Plastic can are light in weight but are easily gnawed by rats. Bulk containers are recommended where large volume of refuse are generated, such as at hotels, restaurants, apartment house, shopping centers, etc. A concrete platform provided with a drain to an approved sewer with a water facilities at the site to facilitate cleaning. On-site processing is intended to improve disposal option, recover valuable resources and prepare material for recovery as a new product or energy. Factors that should be considered in evaluating on-site processing are capabilities, reliabilities, environmental effect, ease of operation, safety to workers and the local community, efficiency, economics and aesthetic look. That is in form of noise, odor, increased traffic, etc. A number of processing technologies have been developed for solid waste management, and one of the job of engineer is to select and design the most sustainable and cost-effective technology or system for a given community. So some of the objectives of solid waste processing includes component separation, that is hand sorting, screening, magnetic separation, air classification for lighter materials such as paper and plastic. So we are sorting out this material. Then volume reduction. So baling, shredding and incineration are applied for this volume reduction. So next process is size reduction by shredding or grinding. Next is resource recovery. So by applying the processes like composting, energy recovery, material recovery, so resources recovery is done. On-site handling method and principle involve public attitude, individual belief, or ultimately affect the public health. It is an actively associated with the handling of solid waste until they are placed in the container used for their storage before collection. This may take place at time before, during, or after the storage. The importance of on-site handling of solid waste is to reduce volume of waste generated, alter the physical form of solid waste, and recover the unstable material. So on-site handling methods are classified as segregation, shredding, grinding, and composting. So segregation of waste into degradable and non-degradable waste is to be done to recover or divert non-degradable waste and degradable item to its recycling plant, and if possible, it can be reused. It is a tedious process which therefore needs labor. Magnet can also be used to segregate ferrous metals. This process will help in reducing the amount of waste going for composting and also earn money through selling waste to recycling plant. Next is shredding or pulverizing. What is shredding or pulverizing? This process involves in size reduction of organic waste before it goes for composting. This process reduces the overall volume by 40%. It will increase the surface area availability for bacterial activity for decomposition and facilitate easy handling of moisture content and aeration. Next is composting. Solid waste composting for use as a soil amendment, fertilizer or growth medium. Aerobic composting is one of the cheapest and easiest methods that are being available for municipal solid waste. There are two fundamental types of composting techniques. First one is open or windrow composting, in that a slower process conducted outdoor with simple equipment. And second one is enclosed system composting, where composting is performed in a building, tank, box, container or vessel on site. Next important is after storage and handling, the next is transportation of solid waste. The waste is transported from storage depot to the disposal site in tractor trolleys or ill-designed open trucks. Though it has been instructed by the law that the transportation must be done in closed container only, the industrial waste must be transported separately and must be disposed in a safe way after suitable treatment. Any type of hazardous waste should be labeled and coded so that in case of accident, the emergency services know how to handle a spillage. So in this image, you can see the transportation of solid waste. Next is waste handling and transport. Waste handling and separation involves activities associated with waste management until the waste is placed in storage container for collection. Handling also encompasses the movement of loaded container to the point of collection. Waste is transferred from smaller collection vehicle to the larger collection equipment. As you can see, this is the smaller container and this is the larger container vehicle. Just transfer this waste from this bin to this larger container vehicle.